South African, a very warm welcome to you. Happy Monday and welcome to Afternoon Express. My name is Jeannie Dean.
Absolutely, I'm Bonnie Bulu. Hope you had an awesome weekend. It's the brand new start to the week and here's some inspiration today.
No, we are completely inspired. In fact, we're interviewing two amazing entrepreneurs from Khayelitsha. The one is a man they call the Spinach King, so we're going to learn about Popeye and muscles and the rest of it. And the other is a really interesting guy who started a health revolution in the township by starting a café selling healthy foods.
Yeah, it sounds absolutely incredible. And then we chat to Sizwe Nzima, who started delivering medication to his grandmother on his bicycle, and a couple of years later, it's grown into a full-blown delivery service with Amazing. Over 1,000 customers. Isn't that incredible?
It's absolutely incredible. And the question we are asking you today on social media is, have you started a new health and wellness challenge for 2017? And what are they? Let us know on our Facebook page, Afternoon Express Online, and of course our Twitter, which is Afternoon Chat, and of course the hashtag Afternoon Express. What is
any
your
health
new
resolutions you have? Were you about to ask me
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I was going to ask you.
The usual, just exercise every day, drink lots more water, and
yes.
rest more.
Yeah, I'm just going to start paying my personal trainers to stop making me lunch and start smacking all the rubbish food out of my hand. And you know what? Today, lunch is going to be amazing and so healthy, and I cannot wait for it because the only thing I've eaten today is my lipstick.
Well, I promise you what we're making in the kitchen today is going to be so much better than that. Good afternoon, South Africa, and welcome to a brand new week on Afternoon Express. What an inspiring show we've got lined up for you today. Not only do we have those incredible entrepreneurs with us in the loft, we're also going to be speaking about a really cool organization that's training up the future leaders of our country, and I cannot wait to see what it is that they've got to share with us on the show. We've mentioned all the delicious treats we're going to be making on the show today, and we're all talking about our health benefits. And so today, Clem has got some really cool ideas on how to incorporate that all-important ingredient, spinach, into our diet. Mm-hmm. Have you even forgotten what Popeye even sounds like? What is this?
What does he sound like? My word, how
Popeye,
old am I?
No,
I'm sorry, Dan, that's not it.
We can't remember what Popeye sounds like at all, but we're going to be incorporating spinach into a lot of our dishes today and doing it oh so cleverly.
It is, and it's kind of like taking an ingredient that we know so well and putting a modern spin on it. So I'm going to show you two amazing dishes. One is a protein-packed spinach wrap. That's almost a wrap. Yeah.
I like it. You're putting a spinach on a wrap. I see.
And in my other dish, I'm going to use my favorite grain of all time, spelt, in a beautiful multi-vegetable salad. It's going to be so, so, so good.
Nice ingredients putting into the show today, and I cannot wait to cook with you guys on the show today. It is birthday week today, end of this week. It's going to be my birthday, so I'm looking for some really cool recipes to use for the brand new year, especially when it comes to all of those health benefits. What are people doing for your health benefits, and what are your sort of health resolutions for the year? I'd love to hear from you guys on our social sites. Also today, what I'd love you to do is give us a call. 083-913-3728 is the number you guys can dial to get hold of us on the show and share with us. Not only are you cooking today on the show, you've got a really cool experience recently.
So every now and then they let me leave my desk and the kitchen and I get to wander the streets.
With your chain on and your little shock collar.
A little bit, so they kind of like monitor me. So I really had an amazing experience visiting Lufefe, who's known as the Spinach King. Mm-hmm. And the man's so passionate about what he does, and what he does is spinach. So kind of like that's inspiration for today's dish.
Lovely.
What do you think?
You've brought a friend with you in the loft today. What is going on?
I love that you've pointed it out because you're going to have to work for your dinner tonight, Dad.
Oh, gosh.
So I need you to hop onto the bike and start pedaling. And if you want to find out where that actually comes from,
oh my word, you'll have to find out on the show.
Are you comfortable?
Wait, I'm getting in. I'm getting my feet like clicked in here. Is it on like, oh
yes,
my gosh.
Yes,
look at that.
You're going to start working for your dinner.
I'm working for my dinner. And while I do this, take a look at exactly what Clem got up to with this beautiful device and the ingredient, magic ingredient of spinach.
I'm in Khayelitsha today to meet someone who, quite frankly, planted the seeds to his own success. And in doing so, uplifted a community. I'm here to find out how he did that and how he got Khayelitsha eating green. Lufefe, it's so nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too, sir.
So tell me about yourself and where Spinach King started.
My name is Lufefe Nomjana, also known as the Spinach King of South Africa. I'm a social entrepreneur and I run a company called Spinach King Healthy Food Café Bakery, giving access to healthy foods to people that need it most. And Spinach King was started in 2011. And back then, the business started off in a community garden where I was volunteering there, working with the community and making sure that their harvest is sold door to door. So I felt in love with spinach in the midst of working in the garden and decided to research more about the spinach. And I discovered that one spinach leaf contains almost 13 phytochemicals such as syringeric acids, camphorols, and those are body benefits that are there to boost your health and to prevent you from cardiovascular illnesses and chronic diseases.
What were some of the processes involved in starting the business, and how did the community take to this product?
I started the business after the concept and the research and everything that I went through, voluntary work, through understanding that it's no longer a concept now, it needs to be a business. And then I started off by realizing what I have. And what I had back then was 40 rands in my pocket, a neighbor's oven, bunches of spinach from the garden that I used to volunteer from. So what happened is that I collected those resources, used the neighbor, started with 4 loaves, baking during the night and selling during the day, pushing sales, health education, and as well as awareness to the people while selling at the same time. And it was very difficult to go through because there was no resources and people were not used into the green spinach bread. They were used into brown and white breads. And coming with that initiative was sort of a struggle, but we overcame.
What are the products that you have available today?
The green bread was a low GI bread. And then after the spinach bread, we did muffins. So we had like spinach and feta muffins. And then we also do onion and cheese muffins just to give a variety as well. We also do green burger. So this burger is made up of the green roll, which is gluten-free as well. And then there's this 7 vegetable fry that we put in. And then we have organic spinach, celery, we use as well, like rosemary, basil, and infused green pepper, and as well as red pepper, just to color it and come up with flavor and taste.
What are some of the projects you're currently working on, and how are they aligned with the growth of the business?
At the moment, because of like, we're a company that started out of nothing. We had a crowdfunding campaign in 2013 that made us to reach about 800,000 people throughout the world. And now today, it's of partnerships and collaborations. And there are other companies that we are working with. And also we are trying to make sure that we deal with the healthy lifestyle in the township, but also making sure that it's accessible to everyone. As healthy eating and healthy lifestyle, there's a perception that it's for other people who live in the southern suburbs. So we're trying to make sure that everyone can have access to it wherever and whenever.
So it all started here for you in 2011. How have the gardens changed since then?
It has evolved and changed from a 70% social garden to now a viable 100% commercial garden, because everything that is here is sold, because it's community-based, but it's sustainable because of how they're doing things and the fact that they're selling outside and inside Khayelitsha.
This is your whole story, the full 360, almost. I still need to meet with your neighbor to hear about that one oven that started the whole business.
Her name is Mom Mavis, and I can't wait. Let's go.
Let's go.
Murima. This is Clem, my friend from SABC.
Hello.
I need to ask you, what was it about Lufefe and his dream that made you offer your oven to him?
Because Lufefe was passionate with what he was doing. To bake the bread and the muffins, all of that.
So I must ask you, out of all the products that he makes today, which one is your favorite?
A spinach bread. It was my favorite too.
I must say, I agree with you. The spinach bread is definitely my favorite as well.
Then let's go to the kitchen and see that oven.
Wow, so this is where the first 4 loaves have come from. Has gone from 4 to 24 to over 200 being produced in your own production center. That's quite an inspirational story. And I gotta thank you for the tour today, which has inspired me as well to create a dish very special for you. Obviously gonna have spinach in it, and it's guaranteed to be delicious.
Okay, what an unbelievably inspiring way to start the week and to start the show. Welcome to the show, Lufefe Nomjana. I mean, I'm completely blown away by that story.
I'm flabbergasted.
Thank you.
What an incredible story and what an incredible business.
Thank you so much.
How did the idea come to you?
It came through, you know, I started off, I had 2 businesses that I failed from. So the first one was a clothing retail business. Yeah. Where I was buying clothes from the manufacturer and selling them door to door. So my skill was selling, not knowing anything about business. And from there, I then went to a community garden after failing from those 2 businesses, thinking that maybe I'm not an entrepreneur. Maybe I just need to work and help someone.
So I went there and spent my time 4 months. Within the course of 4 months doing that voluntary work, I then developed their garden, but also I developed the idea of spinach concept, where now I can incorporate spinach in daily consumed products because of the fact that one spinach leaf contains almost 13 phytochemicals, yeah, which are there to boost your health from cardiovascular illnesses, chronic exactly diseases. Apart from that, I mean, after 1930, there was a severe issue of famine and as well as the soil defilement. So the UN and food scientists sat down, pulled on their thinking caps as to what is it that they can do to promote a certain vegetable that can yield fast and that can also heal the pancreatic cancers that people were facing back then.
Absolutely.
So they sat down and they went to Disney and said, you know what, spinach is indeed one vegetable that is outstanding in terms of the turnaround time and as well as the cardiovascular illnesses that it actually tackles. But yeah, apart from that, there was a malnutrition issue, which spinach is very good
and
at.
And it also aids in depression.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What is your dream? How do you, like, I want you to find the most amazing investor who will allow you to roll out a series of Spinach Kings all over the world. Because it is such a brilliant concept and it's doing so good for your community and it's so healthy. So what is your dream? What is your goal? How do you want this to work out?
I mean, it has been 6 years now. You know, it came out very difficult from, you know, educating the community that this is now the green bread from the white and the brown breads that people traditionally were used to. So, and then the education has been, you know, happening for quite some time. The campaigns that I've been doing, bike and blending, and as well as bread on bikes. So there were a couple of health education campaigns that I've done. So now today, we are looking at now the spinach empire, like, nationally and even internationally. There's someone who's doing our franchise in Washington at the moment.
Oh, that
so
is such
be Canada and Mexico. So I'm now actually banking on that kind of a deal and contract, just so it can diffuse that side. But nationally, it's going to be 15 roll out to Durban and Johannesburg.
Amazing. It's absolutely amazing. I cannot wait to taste your bread.
I also just love the look and feel, your branding.
Yeah. And just you.
Everything.
No, thanks.
Yeah, we're so obsessed.
Sure. Oh, and, amazing.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Pleasure is all mine.
Now, earlier on, we asked you on Afternoon Express, of course, we're chatting to young entrepreneurs, and we asked what health challenge have you set for yourself in 2017? And some of you have already responded. And I hope I can find your comments on the Facebook.
We're really good at working the Facebook.
Okay, is this the one, Jeannie?
There's you go and read as many comments as you want.
Aggie Moheti says, no bunny chow, lots of water, less sugar, junk, and sleeping 10 minutes after meal makes me fat. I've joined aerobics this year and I'm feeling relaxed already.
Well, you can actually eat bunny chow if you make it in green spinach bread from the Spinach King.
And you need to consume 50% of what you're consuming every day if you need to get that health and that balance.
Absolutely.
50% of what you consume most, and secondly, vitamin K-based vegetables and fruits
and water. That's incredible. Well, we've got a Spinach King in training in the kitchen.
Go, let's go. It's a bee tiger. Not even either tiger. Bee tiger. Finished. I think it's finished. I think it's done. You can take that out of there. Take that out of there. Come on, Clem. What are you doing?
Too much fun.
Do not have Clem as a gym trainer in your life ever. We're going to be showing you exactly what we made on this bike after the break. Don't go anywhere. Whew. Welcome, you're back with us in the Afternoon Express Loft, and we're in the kitchen today trying to explore the health benefits of delicious, delicious food. Clem Pedro is with us, as well as Lufefe. It's good to have both of you here today because we're exploring some of the really cool things we can do with spinach.
Cool, right, man.
So, are you ready for this one?
Yes.
This is inspired from the day spent with you touring, which you called the Spinach King Route.
The Spinach King Route,
okay,
yes.
Okay, so this is a dish inspired from that. It's going to be a protein-packed wrap. Let's get started. Really simple. So I'm going to first say, Dan, awesome work, eh?
I worked for my dinner tonight. I cycled my...
You cycled your own smoothie.
Yeah, I wouldn't say what I cycled off, but I'll say I cycled that thing off badly to get this done and dusted, and our mixture's ready.
Sure.
If you don't have
You've got two things.
Yes.
Healthy eating and healthy lifestyle.
Well, there you
go. Time.
Use myself. I like this. If you don't have that fancy bike at home, what you got to do is use one of these blenders.
There's always a benefit.
Pop some spinach in there. And then free-range eggs always. They go in. So it's kind of a wrap, but what I've done is I created the wrap, the base of the wrap, just using two ingredients, spinach and eggs.
And eggs.
No flour, no grain, or nothing in there.
The spinach itself, obviously, we know is very healthy for you, but I mean the health benefits of spinach itself, like the most important thing that we find is lacking?
I think the most important thing about spinach, it consists of chlorophyll. Uh-huh. So the chlorophyll that you find from the spinach is the one that actually helps you to decrease chances of pancreatic cancers and the cancers. So you'll find that it's very good at actually decreasing and also making sure that it balances.
Apart from that,
but there are camphorols there, and there are also other, you know, minerals and vitamins such as vitamin C, which is citrus acids, and then also there's iron, vitamin A as well, which is very good and essential for malnutrition and kwashioko issues that we're facing in Africa.
Yeah, so that's why it's important to incorporate it into your diet. A lot of people don't necessarily, and they're taking supplements, or those who maybe can't afford to get the supplements, to get into your diet is quite a hard thing to do, to find those. And spinach is such a nice ingredient.
It is.
What did you throw in there now?
Cool. So what I've done is I've created a little more flavor. It's just optional. Mm-hmm. Added some Parmesan cheese in it, black pepper, because spinach and black pepper are best friends.
Wow. Yes.
And a little bit of salt, because you've got the Parmesan in there already. It's got that nice seasoning for you. Mm-hmm. And added some more spinach. You want it to be really, really green. So you give it another blitz, bring it together. And what you're going to end up with,
what I created myself, ladies and gentlemen.
So, let's get started and show you how easy
this
is.
Credit to you.
So I've got a pan, and just a little bit of oil goes in. That's all I need.
Have you made these wraps before? Is this a first for you, Lufefe?
This one is the first for me, and that's why I'm...
He's watching it closely, he's analysing the business model. Kevin's going to steal your business from you.
It's fine, I'm all about that sharing in 2017.
Yeah, he's going to buy some franchises.
Yeah. There we go. So there we go. That's all it is. It's in a stock cooking like a pancake. Dan, can you pass my spatula there?
Oh, sure. And they come out looking something like this.
Yes, that's so true. So let me get this one cooking. Looking cool. Literally, all you need to do is cook it for about, I'd say about 40 seconds, and you just start loosening it. You can see it's already, it really holds well. We talk about egg being a binding agent, so you can imagine it's really going to hold well in the pan.
When it cooks nicely.
And these are also really great ingredients that everybody should have at home. I mean, we should all have eggs at home.
Yes.
And obviously, following the story, we're all, as of today, going to always have spinach in our houses.
Exactly.
Cool, so they just go. We're nearly there. So yeah, so what you're gonna do is just turn it over after 40 seconds, then the other side cooks for 10 seconds. Let me just turn this heat off, because I've got some that I've done for us already.
No carb. It's a no carb.
There we go, no carbs at all.
No carbs.
So what's happened is 6 eggs and the spinach that we've used give us 6 wraps, which is really great. When we think about the way that the ingredient is stretched.
So 1 egg per wrap.
This is perfect.
Perfect.
So you're getting your sort of proteins in there, you're getting your spinach
and
in there.
And this is a gluten-free roll. Yes. This is a gluten-free wrap.
There we go.
Which is low carb, and that's what we're actually looking forward to these days.
Okay, so let's get started on prepping the... We can't just have a wrap. We've got to have fillings for it.
Mm-hmm.
So let's get started. So we've got some chicken that I just roasted off in the oven. Again, you can fry that off, but you know it's so much easier and healthier in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
Then I've got some spring onions, which I saw a lot of at the farm that we went to.
Yeah,
those farms are so inspiring.
Spring onion grows really, really well. They're quite a resilient thing to grow.
Very. And I love them so much. I mean, it adds so much flavor to a dish. So
I always thought that someone told me once that spring onion was really easy to grow. Then I tried to grow normal bulb onions, and I remember they came out like flat. They were ridiculous. They were terrible. It's such a hard thing to grow. So
it's an artisanal.
I mean, for space issues as well, you'll find that the green onion can grow in between any vegetable or any plant that you can plant. So basically, if we have like issues of land or land that you don't have much land, then you can just do an urban agriculture, permaculture sort of a thing, where you're mixing your vegetables in one.
This is so exciting to hear him talking about this stuff, because obviously we're making delicious food on the show, but what I find fascinating is this year I'm working quite closely with an organization that's trying to improve the sort of living conditions in some of the homeless, and they're incorporating growing facilities. They're building a plot of land, they're growing a whole bunch of really cool things on the land, and it's a sustainable project. You're employing people to work on that
food
project,
security as well.
You're allowing them to work towards the community, health structures. It's amazing.
It is. Through vegetable and through plantation and farming.
Lovely.
Cool. So what I've done is I've added some cream cheese, some of that spring onion chopped up, and some extra spinach, because you can't have too much.
Never.
Some chicken.
Too much spinach in the wrap. Lovely.
Just like that. It was easy. Dan, can you pass me that jar of salsa?
Sure,
please,
I can.
Please, dude.
Should I open it for you?
Yeah. Use a few muscles.
Marshalls. Now you're adding a bit of spice to this, because you've got a nice little like, sort of subtle flavors that you've got over there.
And also, tomato's got a bit of that acidity to it, so like we always use lemon to brighten up the flavors of a dish. That's exactly what the salsa does. And if you want that spice, a little bit of sriracha goes in.
If you want that spice to make it nice, add some spinach to your...
everything.
Rhymes with spinach.
And all you gotta do is roll it up.
Add some spinach while you play Quidditch.
And then you're gonna
Look at that. That's our first wrap done. What do you think,
guys? Yum, Clem. You nailed this one. Well done. Very, very well done. Let's give him a round of applause.
service.
Yeah, thank you guys. So I'm going to keep on going. But actually, do you want to try it? Oh, wait, wait, wait. I know why he can't.
I would love to.
Because he's a vegetarian. Mm. And that's why in part two, making a beautiful, beautiful vegetarian dish for you.
Okay, that
lovely. That would be great, and looking forward to that.
It's a good surprise for you. Don't forget to get all these details on how to make these recipes on our website. It's afternoonexpress.co.za. It's a great platform to find everything we make on the show. Recipes, shopping lists, everything else can be found there. So make sure you guys go and check that out. It's such a great thing to keep in mind because it's a nice way to be creative with your healthy foods. I know that you're supporting someone doing amazing, amazing work with these sort of things. So that's really, really cool. While you guys are on your mobile devices and checking out our website and downloading the recipes, I wanted to read through some of the comments that came through. We're asking you guys on the social media question for today. What health challenge have you set for yourself in 2017? We look ridiculous, don't you think?
Yeah, thank you. We're looking
so handsome,
good.
All of Stunning. Us. So handsome. Yeah, let's read some of these comments. We've read those ones. Sir Avili says, I want to exercise regularly to prevent cardiac complexities and build a masculine body. Loving Genie D, there we go. And then Solofelo says, no fizzy drinks for me and my family. And cycling with my little sister twice a week. Maybe you should come join us in the loft, little fellow, and show me how to cycle on this bike better.
Sure.
Thanks, Diane, for your comment there. I appreciate that. That's very sweet of you. Dinoa says, I recently started jogging in the morning. I never enjoyed road work, but now I love it. Mm-hmm. Even looking forward to a 15-kilometer hike this weekend. 15Ks, guys!
That's crazy. And there's a great commitment.
Well done to her. Run like 5 kilometers. That's insane. You know, that's really cool. And Notorious Mabilane says, to eat healthy food because I eat a lot of unhealthy food. I also want to start going to the gym because I gained some weight over the festive season. As we all did, Notorious. Do not stress about that. Just make sure that you spend as much time as you can enjoying your lifestyle, but at the same time looking after that body of yours. More recipes coming later on Afternoon Express. Over to you, ladies.
I'm definitely picking up whatever you guys are dropping in that kitchen. It looks... delicious. But I mean, you know, when you watch stories like what we had now with the Spinach King on the show, I'm just so consistently inspired by like this emergence of beauty in the country.
Absolutely. Like, it's just amazing. Makes me, every day on this couch makes me fall in love with this country more.
I know,
and more.
I'm so happy.
We're going to take a short break, and when we return, we chat to another young man who's revolutionizing the health sector, Sizwe Nzima. Don't go away.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express this glorious Monday afternoon. Now, in 2013, Sizwe Nzima started a medication delivery service called Aiza Express with only one customer, his grandmother. Today, his business has evolved to become Aiza Health. And he now services a growing customer base of more than 1,000 people in Khayelitsha. And he provides employment and skills training to the youth in his community. Welcome to the show.
Wow. Thank you very much.
How beautifully inspiring. Where did the idea come from?
Well, the idea came from a personal experience. So as a young boy, I used to collect chronic medication for my grandparents, both my grandma and my grandpa, because I grew up with them. And through this whole process, I've been experiencing the normal problems that we see in South Africa every day at public clinics, the long queues, the long waiting hours, some of the people actually not even deciding to collect their vital treatment. And this is chronic treatment that we're talking about.
Whoa.
People need these drugs to take every day. And for me, when everybody was complaining about the lack of service and poor services, and that's where my entrepreneurial skills came in. When I saw a problem, when everyone saw a problem, I saw an opportunity. And I said to myself, instead of pointing at the government and saying this and that, they need to do this, I said, I'll take the responsibility to come up with a solution that will solve the problem.
I love the confidence with which you say, that's when my entrepreneurial skills came in.
Is it not, like, how do you legally collect medication for someone else, especially if it's chronic medication? Because isn't that by prescription?
There's also so much bureaucracy around it as well.
Yeah.
All these, how do these you hoops to jump through?
Well, the biggest, one of my biggest challenges is the laws and the regulation and bureaucracy.
Sure.
That has been so tough for me. But what happens is there are certain licenses that you need to get in order to handle and distribute drugs. So I've went through the process of actually acquiring them. So my company now is a fully qualified, compliant courier pharmacy. So
amazing.
I've got the necessary, because I've also got the pharmacy side where I can take drugs and hold them within the specified temperature and site and distribute them according to the temperature, because I've designed a box that allows you know, the cooler container to keep the medication in. So I've had to jump through those loops. As an entrepreneur, you have to.
Yeah. So your company started out as Iyeza Express, and then it grew into Iyeza Health.
Yes, the company started from Iyeza Express, which was the normal delivery service of medication. Right. But then as I went on, I discovered that there are certain licenses that I needed to have, like the pharmacy licenses and the dispensing license. So I got those, and then I got my courier certificate and my courier license. So I then combined those to sort of get the compliance around the courier pharmacy.
Yeah.
So now it's called Iyeza Health, and we're not just only looking at distributing drugs, but it's built around being a health logistics company that makes health-related products more accessible for the community.
And health solutions in general.
Can I ask a business... Oh, sorry.
So basically what I have here is a new initiative that I'm working on. So when I talked about, we're not only just distributing drugs to the community. So what we have here is an HIV self-test kit. So the law has been passed with WHO from the 1st of September as self-testing can be sold online and at pharmacies. Yeah. So what we're doing is, so why did I go into this industry? South Africa's got the highest HIV prevalence in the world, not even the continent, in the world. And the problem is that there are a lot of people who are unaware of their statuses, and people don't go to clinics to test. Mm-hmm. So what I'm basically doing is by introducing the eye test, it allows you to order the kit online discreetly, and the kit can be delivered to your doorstep.
Wow.
Now you can screen yourself, and then we link you to treatment by following up with you to calls, and then how do we link if you're positive, we link you to treatment and doctors. Yeah. If you're negative, how do we advise you to stay negative so that the infection rate decreases in South Africa?
Wow.
And it's youth majority that are HIV positive.
Brilliant.
Yes. So it's a very easy to use kit, very user friendly.
And you invented this. This is your concept.
So it's a partnership with a company from Australia, Otomo Diagnostics. So they manufactured the cassette, and then we assemble everything,
the parts,
and the parts. And the branding is Iyeza. So that's the only two things you need.
Amazing.
That is why it is considered to be a self-test.
And everybody needs to get tested.
Absolutely. Everybody needs to get tested.
Everyone needs one of those kits at home.
So how do your people travel, your delivery people? Are you still on bikes?
Yes.
How does it work now?
Yes, we use bicycles as a mode of transport. Number one, it's green.
It's green.
Number two, it's cost-effective.
Absolutely.
Number three, it's also very, you know, it allows us to navigate the township, because you might find that someone's house is in the deepest shacks of Khayelitsha.
Yeah.
Guess what? A panel van can't get there. But with our bikes, we can easily navigate. We don't have to find parking. We don't pay for parking. What's the nice thing is that we don't even pay for petrol. I see all the guys with cars complaining when petrol goes up.
Amazing.
We don't pay for petrol.
So
it allows us to also keep my drivers fit. And I also do cycle.
Yeah.
So sometimes
that's
I am on the road.
That's why you look so fit as well. Okay, but then I have to ask you a business question. As an entrepreneur, so I think the idea is brilliant because, you know, old people who need chronic medication, it's a mission for them to get to these clinics and stuff to get it. So you're doing an amazing service. But how are you making money? Because these people also obviously can't afford to pay you.
So
are the hospitals now kind of licensing you to do this?
So basically what we do is currently at the moment we charge the patient, because it is still the patient's responsibility to collect their drugs.
Right.
But what happens is there is an initiative that we're going to be running with the government, that we're looking at partnering with them, where they subsidize a part of the fee, because it is part of the mandate to make health access more accessible for the public. So we're looking at running that initiative, but we're going to be piloted in Khayelitsha in a set of a contract. And then the goal is, how do I replicate the model out everywhere in South Africa? You go to Soweto, you see the same thing when you walk into a public facility. You go to Durban, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
But how do I build up small franchises that can be youth run? My goal is, how do I make youth get them into jobs and get them running the concept?
How do your customers find you? Is it word of mouth mostly?
Mostly it's word of mouth, and at most of the time I've got marketers at the clinic. So these are guys that I've trained, and they explain to people, and they sign people up, and they explain to people the process and how you would pay. So that's how we do it at the moment. The patient still pays, but we are moving into a delivery service that is accessible for everyone, where everyone doesn't need to pay.
What's your background? What were you doing before this? Because it seems to me that you're pretty on it when it comes to a business plan, and you're extremely entrepreneurial. I mean, was this your first go at business?
Well, it wasn't my first go. So we had a small company with my friend Juan de Sile, where we started an events company. And I've learned a lot from that, because we used to do small events at schools, organize DJs. Yeah. We failed. Because of one thing, we blew the money. When the money started, we started blowing the
you
money.
You were just making it rain.
But I learned a lot.
Yeah,
and so my background is in logistics. So I studied logistics, and we went to the same business school with Lufefe Nomjana. So we used to be in the same.
Wow, you guys. Which business school is this?
So this is the Raymond Ackerman Academy Entrepreneurial Development. It's situated at UCT, at the Graduate School of Business. So me and Lufefe Nomjana, we used to be there next to each other and just talk business, talk ideas. How can we, improve the township?
Amazing.
Wow, you guys are inspiring.
It's so inspiring. And, of course, the message is that, you know, not every business that you focus on is going to be a huge success. Sometimes you fail. It's about getting back on that bicycle. Somebody who isn't on his bicycle at the moment.
Maybe I'm not on my bicycle, but all I'm going to say to you, South Africa, is hashtag Monday Motivation. What incredible guests we've got on the show today. And all the inspiration is going to continue after the break. We meet two gentlemen, both from different communities across South Africa, both incredibly bright minds, both wanted to study at university but didn't have the funds to continue. And along came a really, really cool organization called MAD. They met up, and these two gents are now employed as lawyers and are the future leaders of our country. We meet them next. Welcome back. It's good to have you with us on Afternoon Express today. Now, if you're a My School card holder and a regular Woolies shopper like myself, and you're wondering how the funds raised through the My School, My Village, My Planet fundraising programs are helping to make a difference, then look no further than today's show. The Make a Difference Leadership Foundation really lives up to its name in making a difference in the lives of young South Africans all over the country. Now, with the help of the Woolworths My School program, the foundation works towards uplifting students and giving them the support and resources necessary to reach their goals. South Africa, you can make a massive impact simply by shopping. And it's so great to see so many amazing initiatives being supported by you in the My School program. Not least of all, the MAD Leadership Foundation, who we have on our couch with us today. We're joined by Helette Peterser, CEO of the MAD Leadership Foundation, and Gaddafi, as well as Awonke. They're two of the foundation's graduates. So guys, welcome to our loft. It's so good to have all of you with us.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for having us.
I'm so excited because I think you guys this year were the charity that I chose to, well, the organization I chose to put money towards from being part of the program. And I'm so glad to see such progress happening with what you do. Let's unpack what the MAD Leadership Foundation does.
So MAD was founded in 2003 by Franchot Pinor and a group of like-minded friends. And what they wanted to do is they wanted to give educational opportunities to young people with leadership potential, because we want to make a contribution to the future of South Africa, and what better way than to train its future leaders. Yeah. It's quite a comprehensive scholarship, so we provide not only tuition fees, we also provide for pocket money when they're at university, for textbooks, stationery, school uniform, and it's a lengthy a scholarship program. What I always say is when a grade 8 gets this scholarship, I don't think they realize the impact it will have on their lives, because we commit from grade 8 until they have finished their first degree at university or whichever tertiary institution they choose. So it's an amazing opportunity, but they have to work really, really hard to get here. Mm. It's not a charity. Yeah. It's something for deserving young leaders who's really gone through a rigorous intake process to get to the point where they're awarded this scholarship.
There is such a need in our country, and I'm glad you mentioned this fact about these people need to be hard-working. Yeah. It's such an interesting one because so many of our South Africans are hard-working and in so much need for these kind of services that you guys offer. Yes. So it must be such a heartbreaking thing, but also such a like an exciting process at the same time, selecting these individual students. So how do you take them in? Because I think mom's already on your website right now, busy applying for their kids. How do you choose which kids you take onto the program, which ones you don't?
Listen, the best and the worst part of my job is the intake process, because just to give you an idea, we don't really advertise the scholarships. People who Google would find out about it, etc. And then we would get around 300 applications. Our intake process end of last year, we had around 300 applications. Then we do a paper selection to see that they meet the basic criteria. Yeah. After that, they go through a process of psychometric testing and leadership assessments. And then we get recommendations from the psychologist who goes through to the final round of interviews. We end up interviewing around 50 potential scholars. And at the end of the day, we award around 35 scholarships. So it's just a little more than 10% of the total number of applicants that actually get the scholarship. If we had more funds, we would definitely award more scholarships. We're literally the only thing keeping us back from growing even bigger as an organization is financial resources.
And as we know, leadership is one of the skills lacking the most in the kind of generation moving forward in these industries. And I know you two gents are nodding profusely. I must first start this interview by giving you guys both handshakes, because I really think I'm really proud of the work that you guys have done and to be where you are. You two, obviously both incredible minds. Both of you have gone to go and study law at university and then are now working for the same law firm, which is so exciting. I remember when I left high school, I didn't know what I wanted to do. I had all the privileges and all the opportunities open to me, and I was still this bratty little kid who wanted to get in. You guys had to work so much harder than me and many other South Africans had to do to get to where you are today. So let's unpack a bit of your stories and like sort of your involvement with this Leadership Academy and what it's taught you.
I think the first thing I'll say at the onset is that I think our stories are, they're very much similar to all the other stories that you hear in townships. The only difference between Awonke and myself is that we were blessed enough to have the opportunities that allowed us to excel academically. And that's where Matt came in. I became involved with the Make a Difference Leadership Foundation as I returned from the US. I did my high schooling, or completed it rather, in Mississippi at the Pinewood School. And I'd always known that I wanted to study law. Mm. It was something that fascinated to me and it touched home. I did not know how to get about that. And particularly, I also did not know which field of law and how to turn a dream into a feasible career option. And the whole comprehensive and this wholesome outlook that Matt has, Khayelitsha touched on several of the facets that are intertwined. But what you tend to find is that Matt is committed not only on educating the mind, but also the heart. It takes a wraparound approach on making sure that it's not enough that you go to class and get your degree. There's also vital skills that you need. There's emotional intelligence that you need to equip yourself for. Mm. And there's also certain resources that we take for granted, you know. And I think had it not been for MAD, the reality, or at least the realization thereof, of a guy like me from Mamelodi, coming from a small community and ending up to working at one of the most reputable family law firms in Cape Town, that would not have been a dream come true. And that's why I'm so appreciative of that.
Yes, man, I love that. And I think what we're starting to realize about the important leaders, the leaders from our sort of global communities and even our local ones, that when they came into power, positions of resource and authority, their protocol was not to sit back, relax, and I'll take it on. Matt are teaching you skills about what impact you're making in your community, that you now have a role to play beyond just the resources that you've got. With great power comes great responsibility. What was it that changed about your personality? I mean, even if it's not about the sort of, I really want to unpack your story of progress.
Yeah. Okay. The program has given me quite a lot of opportunities, really valuable opportunities. Mm. I mean, the opportunity to pursue an education at university. the opportunity to have gone overseas at one of the programs, golf day, golf tournament, fundraisers that I've been able to go to. And really, as Hilaire touched on the leadership summit, the annual leadership summits that we have, those are the sort of platforms that we get involved with and inspire us to also, as leaders, because really leadership is about empowering yourself and being able to empower others, and also then replicate that difference making in the lives of those around us, in our communities, in whatever space you're in. You don't need a title to actually lead or be a leader.
And every circumstance you find yourself in is going to require some kind of leadership capability. It's looking beyond oneself towards the greater good of the circumstances. And he's touched on it, a few of the topics. But in your opinion, what is it about leadership that our country desperately needs? And what are you teaching these youngsters about leadership?
So what we try to develop is for each of our scholars to identify their leadership style, but whatever the leadership style is, to base it on solid leadership values, on passion, commitment, honesty, integrity, hard work, to make sure that they are aware that it's not just all glamorous to get to the top. You have to work hard, and once you're there, you have to take care of those around you. And even if you don't get to the top, if you're a teacher in a community school, there will come a time when there's a need for you to take a stand for what's right.
Step
and
up.
That's exactly. So we don't say Gaddafi and Awonki has to be CEOs or the next president, even though I'm quite sure that
yes.
one of them would pursue a political career. What we want is for them to, when there's a moment for you to stand up for what's right, to do it and to be a voice for others who don't have a voice.
I'm so passionate. You're getting me all riled up because that's exactly what our country needs now. Nobody is standing up for what is right and what is true, objectively speaking. So you two are going to be those voices in your community. So really, really well done to both of you. When I say dodgy things on a live television show, I'm coming to you for representation. I want that to happen in case I get fired at some point. I want to read some of the social media comments we're coming through. Hope you guys have got your own sort of plans for the year when it comes to your health, because that's what we were asking on our Facebook page. I'm going to read through some of those comments that we had, particularly health challenges that you set for yourself in 2017. Let's get some of the ones we haven't read out so far. Iketeng says, I want to stay away from junk food. I want to stay fit, exercise a lot, and go to gym, which seems to be the generic response, I think, from everybody so far. Hunandi says, eating fresh, healthy food gives our bodies a go. And I agree. So it's almost like that raw vegan diet sort of will be a good option for you there. Diane says, more water, less fizzy, sugary drinks. I love that. And then Tem Banani says, Mr. Spinach King. That's exactly what we're all going to move our diets to, it sounds like, if we could. Lots of other comments coming through. We'd love to hear from you on our Facebook page, Afternoon Express. You guys can let us know exactly what your health challenges you're setting for yourself are this festive season, or the whole festive season's done and dusted, for the rest of the year if you want to. Welcome back. It's good to have you with us on this Motivation Monday on Afternoon Express. It's also happening to be a meat-free Monday in this part of the cooking on Afternoon Express. Clem is going to be showing us how to make some really cool, delicious vegetarian dishes, incorporating, I'm not even joking with you, every vegetable that I think could ever have been grown in your garden is now officially in a dish. And we're using your favorite ingredient for 2017, spelt.
It is, absolutely. And I've given this recipe a very easy name, like I always do give my recipes very simple names. It's the spicy spinach and spelt salad.
Spicy spinach and spelt salad. We should try and see if we can say that a couple of times over. Go.
Spicy spinach, spelt salad, spicy spinach, spelt salad.
Spicy spinach and spelt salad. Spicy spinach and spelt salad. Spelt spinach. Oh, wow.
No, don't even. Okay,
call it now and try and do our tongue twister with us. 0839133728.
So look at this. So what I've got in here is some beetroot that's just cubed up. And it's raw. Quite strange because people normally cook beetroot till it's like completely soft and then they end up eating it. Keep it raw. It's actually really great. It's really sweet.
Lovely.
What I'm doing is frying the outside, creating a little bit of texture to it.
Not only texture, it's also bringing out a bit of that flavor inside of it as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. So some red onion goes in, some orange peppers. I love playing around with peppers. I think people avoid it so much because it's got such a strong taste.
Yeah.
But give it a try. It's really great and really good for you. And add so much crunch and color to a pan. I mean, look at that.
Lovely.
We're like not even halfway
yet.
Wow. Such a beautiful color. Broccoli, also.
A little bit of broccoli.
Broccoli is really great eaten raw. Like you should. Mm-hmm.
I do. I actually had that for lunch today. I had raw broccoli with guacamole. And
there
then I also had like my julienne carottes.
There we go. So all I'm doing is giving it a quick fry. I don't want to cook it too much. I want to retain. This is super crunchy. Food that you have to work for is really great. You got to work to chew this guy.
True. But also, not only that, a lot of people on Facebook were saying that they really want to start eating healthier foods that have got to do with raw ingredients. So, like, the sort of, I know this isn't raw because you're cooking it, but
it's a little bit raw.
Yeah,
and,
yeah, it's cook. In between. So it's keeping things in their natural, you're not cooking all the nutrients out of it, but at the same time, I'm adding flavor with a slight little grill.
Awesome. And I've got some sweet potato that I just roasted in the oven.
Lovely.
This is so good. Sweet, salt, pepper, olive oil, done. In the oven, comes up beautifully crisp and delicious.
Yummy.
Now, we talk about people that are kind of turning over a new leaf and wanting to eat healthier in the new year.
Lol, turn over a new leaf, you see what you did there.
Hey, I just thought about it. But the biggest thing is don't sacrifice flavor for your new health goals, because that's the quickest way that you're going to fall off, and you're going to go back to binge eating those burgers. Keep the food interesting, keep it full of flavor, full of texture, and that way it's going to be a lot easier to maintain this healthier lifestyle.
I like that input. Another one that everyone always says about, besides making it taste good, also don't try and go for all three meals. Don't cut out one thing out of your diet completely, immediately, and try and expect yourself to survive. So if you are the type of person that likes to make a quick, easy pasta in the evening, don't just cut out carbs out of your diet for the rest of the year.
Yeah.
It's not going to work for you. Sometimes start like weaning things off. And starting with cool recipes like this, like your salad in the evening, maybe incorporate more vegetables into it in this sort of way, and that'll get you start like into the process of eating healthy. So. Good idea, Clint.
And I think it's also important that meal prepping is a great thing.
Yeah.
Because you can try to get really busy, and because you're not prepared, you end up eating really bad
Although
foods.
I honestly believe that that's absolute rubbish. I don't think anyone who is busy now is ever going to make the time to go and meal prep for the next day anyway.
My point is, look how quick this is to put a salad together.
Okay.
We're almost out the kitchen already.
And so you can keep it.
Can you add the spalt for me?
Sure, I can.
Spalt is a really amazing grain. I love it so much, using it so much this year. And from last year already, and it's a great, amazing in salads, in curries, really awesome.
Do you want both packs?
Let's go two packs, why not?
And also, obviously, you guys can keep the spelt out of your recipe. Obviously, it's a really nice ingredient to have, especially as an all-day meal, because it's got that low GI added to it. So it's one of the things I wouldn't necessarily try and cut out, because it is so good for you. But you can have it as just a vegetable dish on its own without the spelt, if it's maybe an evening dish. If it's a daytime dish, a sort of lunchtime thing, and maybe an early evening dinner, please incorporate as much spelt as you can, because people always forget your body needs energy. It
and
needs
that's exactly
these
what
things
the gut that
to
does.
Survive.
So, Dan, it's not called spicy for another reason. How many chilies today?
Oh my gosh, you're putting two in today.
Why
oh
not?
My word.
Things are popping.
Love it. Is
that's
that the
great.
Spalt? Is the spalt like almost becoming popcorn?
Exactly, and
I
it's
love
so
it.
True.
It's
got a bit of an outer skin, and that's kind of popping right now. Dan, I need from you some. Yep. Let's see, what are we still missing?
Cheese.
Some lemons.
Lemons.
I can't do without lemons, so can you squeeze some lemon juice in there for me?
Sure.
And then salt and pepper after that. Show me the mussels. Bring it all together.
A little zestiness on here. Yum.
Really cool, really fresh. And what you can do now, some salt and pepper.
A little bit of seasoning.
Things are really popping, that's really great.
It sounds so yum. It's a fun little like game, I guess you can play in the kitchen.
Pip in the nose, but I'm not gonna sneeze.
We're making it pop and lock in the afternoon express laugh.
Okay, cool. What I'm gonna do, Dan, is I'm actually going to tip it and you just scoop into the dish. What do you think?
Fine.
Cool, here you go. Let's go. Don't get it all
I
on the
got
table.
The scoop in the lap. We're going to be making soup next. No, we're not, actually.
No, we're not. That's winter.
Salad. Yeah, sorry. I'm just trying to be cool, dude.
What do you think? Nice
my
and spicy?
Swag. It's Monday.
Salad swag.
Kill my vibe.
You got
looks
some
amazing.
Cool salad swag there, my friend.
Thank you. That looks absolutely amazing. It's hearty. It's healthy. It's full of ingredients. And it's full of lovely, what you call it?
Flavor. Nutrition.
Nutrition. Yeah. Nutrition. And it's also got that all-important ingredient, spinach, thrown in there. So make sure that you guys get that made up. It's all the details on our website, afternoonexpress.co.za.
Go, my friend. Be free.
Off I go, and I'm free to take this to the table.
Run, Forrest, run.
Dinner is served, ladies and gentlemen.
That looks,
that looks
outstanding.
Incredible.
Right.
I'm taking this home with me for supper.
Exactly.
Guys, that's a wrap. And
all
this is a wrap of our show.
By the king of spinach.
We'll see you same time, same place tomorrow. Good night and happy eating, South Africa. Bye.
Ciao.
Bye. You want to dig in?